Hey guys, what's up? It's Andy. Just like in this video, you're gonna see these nice customers come in on a specific vehicle. Guess what? Due to inventory being so low, you're not always gonna have the right car. I'm gonna show you how to sell any customer the vehicles you have in stock so you don't get stuck on the order train. Better get ready for this next year. With inventory being low, you're gonna have to learn how to sell what you have. This video is gonna change everything for you.
Whoa. Clap the room, I'm coming through. They want to see what I'm about. Yeah, I got skills, do it for the thrill. I'm on a paper route.
What do? People get an idea, right? They get an itch. Can I say this? People have an idea, they get an itch. Now I'm going to write on this whiteboard because I got ADD and I want to follow a little process of what's in my head. Don't worry about what's on the whiteboard. People got an itch. They're at home. They want to buy something, right? They're thinking about something. They've seen something they want, or they're having a problem. Whatever it is, these ideas that they come up with on what they want to buy, they're coming up with these ideas at home. Look, no salesperson around. No salesperson. Were you there when they thought about buying something? No. They were on their own. Now watch this. Somebody's here. I got a hubby and a wife, right? See that? They're sitting here, right? And they're wanting to buy something. When they come into my store, who do they meet? Me. All right. Now I'm going to say something. That person is the deciding factor whether they buy anything or they buy nothing. Whether they buy what they want or they get influenced and persuaded to buy something else. This person, whoever that is, will decide, and that's you. So I want you to think about yourself for a minute. If you're watching this, grab a little stick figure, which is what I like to do, and I have to think, hey, that's me, okay? Who can make the switch happen? Only that person. Listen, I'm gonna tell you guys something. Do you know what a closer is? A closer is somebody who's got a good attitude, who's alive, who's got swagger. Write down swagger, write it down. Swagger, alive, energy, fun, good perspective. Write that down. Look, I'm gonna tell you something right now, right? Guy walks in, he says he wants something. This salesperson A over here knows he doesn't have it. He doesn't have swagger. He doesn't have a good attitude. He doesn't have a good perspective. He doesn't have a great mood going on about him. He's not gonna make a switch. It's not gonna happen, guys. I'm telling you right now, I'll give you a million scenarios where a bad attitude killed the deal, okay? I'm a younger sales guy, I can give you a million examples, but let me give you another one. This guy named Bob Tomez walks out when I'm 20 years old, shakes these old people's hands, they say we want a Buick Century. Bob, you know that's a long ass time ago when I said Buick Century, right? All right. But I remember like it's yesterday because I was laughing so hard at this dilliness.
Hey guys, sorry to interrupt the video. Right now is the time to take yourself to a whole new level. Listen, the market is gonna demand you to get more skill right now than you've ever needed to have. And if you do, not only will you become great, but you're gonna make more money than you ever imagined. I would love to talk to you. Tell me what you need help with. Text me right now. If you see on the screen, my cell phone number is 918-210-0254. Let me say that again, 918-210-0254. Shoot me a text message. Tell me what you need help with. I'll reach out and call you. Let's take you to the next level. Let's get back to the video.
And I see these blue hairs pulling up, right? These old people. And I'm like, woo! Bob beats me, goes around the corner. I'm like, damn it. Man, that's my deal. Bob goes up, says hi to him, walks him out on the front line. They look at a couple Buick Centuries. They're all three gold. Lady says, I hate gold. Hate it. Won't take it, save my life. I hate gold. Bob says, gosh, man, it's the only thing I got. Let's go inside and see if I don't have another one in the back. They pull the old deal, same thing you do. They go inside. Bob goes and says, guys, don't have anything else. Only got the gold ones. Sure, you wouldn't take gold if it was a great deal? Guy says, nope, hate gold. Not buying gold. He's like, would you buy anything else? They said, nope. Watch. These people came in to buy a car. Bob sucks. Bob's got a bad attitude. Bob doesn't have any swagger. Bob isn't having fun. Bob doesn't talk to the customers like he owns the world and he can do anything they want to do and he's got magical hands. Okay? Bob's boring. All they want is something that Bob doesn't have because they don't like Bob. Bob is an order taker. He should be working at McDonald's. But guess what? We got some Bobs out there right now. You should write down a piece of paper. Am I acting like Bob? Or do I sound like Andy? Let me explain something to you. I want you to write down three things. Number one, master the craft. Write it down. Number two, study the game. Write it down. Number three, study your industry. Write it down. Guys, if I made $700,000, I know some of you guys might get a little numb to hearing that. That is a very baby number, 700 grand. As a salesperson in a bad economy, because I did what? I studied the game, I mastered the craft, and I studied the industry. Didn't have anybody great to study when I sold. Had a couple people I watched here and there. You guys can know that if you listen to what I say, you can make what I'm telling you that you can make, but you gotta become alive. How does a switch happen? I can give you the scenario right now, and I will, and I'll tell you how switches are made, but if you don't become alive, you're screwed. That lady, that husband right there that Bob was talking to, Bob gave him his card, and he said, hey, listen, if I get another caller, I'll call you. You know what happened? They're walking out to the car, and you know me, I'm like, oh, dang, should I go get it? Like, should I go? And I run out there, I'm like, hey, guys, whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey, I'm the inventory manager. I'm sorry. It's Bob's first day, right? He didn't know. We had a couple other ones in the back. Guys, come on inside for 2 seconds. Let me pull it around for you. They're like, oh, my gosh, okay. Guess what? I'm already cool, cooler than Bob right out the gate. Guess what happens? I run out there. I grab the gold one, right? The one they didn't want. And I grabbed it. I pulled it around the building. And I re-pulled it up front. And I walk up and I say, guys, you're going to owe me a steak dinner. Check this out. Look at this. I said, it's sterling silver. Like the ice silver, the ones everybody wants, we never got, just came off the truck. Lady walks out and she goes, I love it. I can't believe we found the one we were looking for. You know who she was looking for? Me. Not Bob. Bob's dead. Bob acted like he was dead. And Bob wasn't selling nobody nothing that day. How many of you right now, if we ended this video, we didn't cover a damn thing except this. Come alive, get some swagger, and have some freaking belief. Have some certainty in yourself. When I told that lady she's gonna owe me a steak dinner, I can't believe this just showed up. Do you see my heart pouring out in the air? Do you see good vibes coming? It's like literally, can you see good vibes? No, but you can feel them. It's like they were just moving through the customer's body because I felt a certain way about the deal, the car, what they should do. So I made them feel that same way. That's persuading. I say this all the time. You know what a closer is? A closer isn't a person that knows a word track on his heart who just says something and then a customer gets closed. And then they're like, oh, that guy's a closer. Do you hear what he just said? No, a closer's a person that when they walk out, you know they're a closer because they close you on who they are right when they meet you. Hey guys, what's going on, man? Welcome to the store. Beautiful family, my goodness. How did I get so lucky to meet you guys? Number one, welcome to my home. Number two, get ready to be served at the highest level today. I'm gonna take great care of you guys. You remind me of my family. Guys, I'm gonna say this. And some of you, this may seem a little surreal. You're like, nobody acts that way. No? The one percenters do. Okay? You thought today we were going to be talking about the other 99% of the world. 99% of the world is looking for clothes. Today they watched this video and they thought Andy Elliott was going to teach them a little clothes about how to close a deal. You are the close. It's you. Listen, dude, I'm gonna say this right now, okay? You better be training. You better be learning and studying and learning your word tracks, closing, negotiations, objection handling, how to be deadly on the phone. You better be doing all of it. Listen, there's skill on this heart. Trust me, I'm a skilled assassin. But I'm gonna say something to you. The way I feel about everything that I do makes what I say so powerful. When you say something, can someone feel the heart on your words? Write it down. Say, when I speak, do people feel the passion in the heart that I have for them and what I'm saying? Is it there? Yes or no? Listen, you can lie to yourself forever. And I'm gonna tell you this, a lot of you guys have been lying to yourself. 99% of you aren't as good as you think you are. Guess what? I'm a sponge, guys. I get better every single day, every day, till I die. I'm gonna say this, what about you? How much study you've been putting in every day? Okay? You've been unlocking every day? Seriously? I know this. I know you walk into a world where 99% of the people are like a coffin dead. And if you were to walk in like this, you would look a little bit silly. Guys, you don't look silly. You actually get paid what you're freaking worth because you're not like everybody else. You know what? You gotta be so different and so good that you demand the attention of the world. Demand it, okay? And I'm telling you this, it's so easy. It's a switch. You say, look, I believe there's another level of me and my customers aren't getting it. So when someone comes in and they're like, I need a four-wheel drive truck, four-wheel drive truck, when they were sitting at home, like, what does that even mean? Guy says, hey, I need a four-wheel drive truck. I'm like, beautiful, man. Hey, no big deal. Let me ask you this. How often do you use a four-wheel drive? How often? Guy's like, once a year, twice a year. I say, cool, man. How long do you plan on keeping the truck? Guy's like, I don't know, 4 years, 5 years? I'm like, okay, cool, man. Well, four-wheel drive is about $5,000 more money, so obviously every time you push the button, it's costing you about $500. Am I right? Right. Let me ask you a question. The truck you have now is a 2015. Would you agree it's an older truck? Yes. And would you agree times have changed? Yes. Back in 2015, you had to have a four-wheel drive. You had to. But can I ask you a question? Are you taking your truck in the swamp? Or do you just want your truck to be safe for the road so you want a four-wheel drive so if you're in bad weather, you're not gonna get stuck? Which one? Swamps, get stuck. A or B, which one? Guy says, well, I ain't driving in swamps, I'm driving in stuck. I don't wanna get stuck. Cool, man, gotcha. Listen, back in 2015, you had to buy a four-wheel drive. You had to. You know why? Because these newer trucks that are two-wheel drive, I don't have a four-wheel drive, guys, understand that. I've got a two-wheel drive. I'm making the shift over to a two-wheel drive. In 2020, times have changed, people have changed, things have changed. That same driving that you did before that you had to have a four-wheel drive on, that you had to pay an additional $5,000 on, $100 higher in payment, and $500 every time you press the button, these newer trucks having a two-wheel drive traction control or what? Well, one wheel slips, the other wheel will lock and keep it from fishtailing. It's got deposit track where you don't have to buy a four-wheel drive unless you're in the swamp and you just said you weren't. So if I could save you the $5,000, $100 a month in payment, and show you a truck that would guarantee you're not gonna get stuck based off the information you just gave me, would you wanna save the dough? Guy's like, yeah, I'd wanna save the dough. Cool, then let's look at this one, plus gas mileage is gonna be cheaper and you'll save on your insurance. That wouldn't make you mad, would it? Guy's like, nah, I might look at that. Cool, man. You see, manufacturers are getting better, things are changing. Who's the expert? Who's the expert? You are. Let's talk about two things. Let's wrap this up. I'm not gonna take forever because the longer I talk, the more you'll forget about what I've already talked about. Swagger, okay? Swagger, that's it. Confidence, baby. Where's your confidence? Listen, if you care what other people think about you, you'll become the world's biggest bitch every single day. Some of you guys won't change because you are embarrassed to change next to the people that are around you. Knock it off. Knock it freaking off, okay? Guess what you need to do? You need to do it for yourself and quit making yourself pay, your paycheck pay, and your family pay, okay? Guys, become alive. I believe in every single one of you, every one of you. And all I want to tell you to do is this, recreate, recreate. If somebody's watching this right now, if you want help and you feel like you are getting in your own way, you got a mentality block, and you don't know how to grow, you don't know how to change, the thing that I'm saying to you right now is speaking to you, but you don't know how to get there. I want you to do me a favor, Sean. Put your cell phone number in here. We can set up a call with him, okay? You guys are a family. You're Car Sales Nation. Sean's going to drop his cell phone in there, copy and paste it, send a text, say, hey, I want to set up a five-minute call, okay? Want to set up a five-minute call. But listen to me, okay? If you don't want to change, nothing will change. I'm just telling you the truth. Sean's number's in the comments right now. If you don't want to change, nothing will change. Guys, my mentors in life are people that have gone where I want to go. I hope today's video helped you grow. I hope it helped you decide and see what switching a customer looks like. Number one, from the objection handling side, I know there's multiple scenarios. You guys could probably give me thousands of them, okay? But let's talk about this. Let's say I gave you the answer to all the things you needed to do. If you're not the guy I'm telling you, you got to be when you're making the switch, the stuff isn't going to work. Now, by the way, what I'm saying to you right now is a skill. It's a skill. And yes, you can be taught it. And everything that I'm telling you right now that you can do, you can do. And I can teach you how to do it.